flame. Hold on, I can make it rain. Oh, do you hear the thunder? No, don't let it bring you back. Look up and see the light. You're not alone, don't give up like that. All we get, got a ways to go. Break that wall, let the spirit flow.
I know you ain't dead yet. Don't stop to catch your breath. You're going higher and higher, higher and higher. Let go, set me free. Got the streets all I need. You're going higher and higher, higher and higher.
Stadium, random weather, time. Panthers, Patriots. Matt. Oh, what's up, brother? All right, man. Dude, man. Hey, what's your name? Paige is good, huh? She is, man. She, dude, she's not. Yeah, like you said, dude, she's got to be an Ayler. She's got to be Jake's sister. She's damn good. Like, oh no, here we go. Hey, dude, that's freaking funny, man. She, dude, I barely got by her when we were playing in the that Ayler Invitational, and so she's real nice with the Panthers. Yeah, bro. Hey, who's your third game, Matt? Oh, wow. Oh, family affair. Hey, you got to be one of the Ailers, man.
Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA
Sports. Well, I don't know, man. I might just have a freaking terrible game. Hey, Matt, you don't have to talk on the mic.
Looking to make an impact. It's Palmer's Cardinals going up against Stafford's Lions.
Yeah, dude.
Opened way back in 1924, but renovated in 2002. There's a look inside Venerable Soldier Field in Chicago.
Yeah, because... Because
like
the whatchamacallit, Detroit is a dome, so there's no like, so I just wanted to play somewhere else.
Get set to match up with the Arizona Cardinals.
Hell yeah.
That's fielded in the end zone.
Ah, oh, damn.
Dude,
you know what, man? I forgot to freaking change my stream too to the CFL network. So I'm probably gonna have some. Yeah, he's probably gonna dock some points from me. That's what's up. My dude, damn man, we ain't get it in for a minute, dude. Hell yeah, let's do it, man. I need you to play hard, bro. Hell yeah. Bro, me and you, we need to go in lab, bro.
Now a play fake here on first down.
Ew.
And his first pass is incomplete. So he can't.
Damn.
As I watch that unfold, I remembered an expression.
Golly, that's some bull, bro.
Anyways, might as well hold on to the ball.
You know, hell yeah, for real.
Not an actual player. Not a chance at all. Way easier said than done.
Good gosh. What a little.
So second and 10 here.
Are you?
Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Play faked Abdullah. It's Stafford.
Oh, nice read.
And that'll be incomplete.
Wow.
They were searching for the tight end, Darren Fells. And it's third down.
That one didn't quite make it to the target, but that's not always a function of the strength of the arm of the quarterback, is it? Sometimes there's just too much pressure there. In any case, the ball doesn't arrive.
Oh, no. Oh, shiz. Oh, bro. Oh, what can you say?
So now an early third and 10 here on their opening drive.
Oh, word, you bring the heat in like that? Let's get in that first down.
The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
It's a great job by this secondary.
Ah, shoot.
They remind me of a hey. Basketball.
JT, no, this is an actual game, man. I forgot to freaking log out, dude, and go into the what's the CFL network. Oh, man. Hey. JT, can you hear me? Respond in the comments. If you want me to, let's just hit St. Patrick real quick.
Sure. 12 yards on the return that time. And the Cards will take over first.
What do you say? Oh, see, there are other rules. Just further. Oh, okay, so that, all right, so you and I know the rules. I just, damn, dude, I just freaking forgot, man, that I was on my stupid little corny network thing. Oh, geez.
first carry now. This is Johnson. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
Yeah, that wasn't a big run, just a short one there. But guess what? Sometimes you treat it like boxing. You throw that jab out there, and you throw it again, you throw it again, then you come with a big punch later. Maybe they're just trying to set him up.
See if they stay on the ground for second down. Again, it's Johnson. It's a room to maneuver. Nifty footwork at the 45. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. That good for 19 and a first down. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, where that continuity is there, and you
there's
can see
Falcons
the
locker room.
Each other,
there's
the defensive
there's Falcons
right
in locker room.
You're
to
exactly
find
going to be a very long night for the defense, because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, no. I know, but like prayers, I'm sorry, dude. I'm ready for my punishment.
Now Palmer on first down.
Oh, it's
down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. The completion good for three, and it's second down.
That was a nice throw out there to the flat, but they defended that pretty well. The hope is to go ahead and put it on him so he can turn and get upfield and gain additional
yardage. Was there any wind?
It just wasn't anywhere to go on that play.
You're like, man. Let's hurry up and...
Palmer now off the bootleg.
That's smart. Oh, I see that. Wow, nice throw.
Cardinals. Troy Nicholas, 44 yards. And the Cardinals have taken the early lead. Well, that was the fly route for a touchdown, and since he caught that one and scored it, I got to tell the story. Before the game, we were standing there. He was running deep routes, dropped one. It bounced up and just hit me right in the gut, and I said, come on, man, but there was no drop.
Yeah, you okay now?
I'm good.
All right,
good.
We got the ice pack up here. You're just fine. What I loved about it was the subtlety of the route, because everyone knows he's fast. They're going to play him for that route first and foremost, but sometimes it's a head fake. It's varying your speed off the line of scrimmage. It's giving
no, he's going to see you delivering.
Is he going inside? Is he going
outside? Oh, shit.
You know that he just took off past him.
Damn, I feel bad, bro.
Again.
Wait.
Dawson now to kick this one away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Here's
all right,
the Detroit
let's do
offense
this.
Now as they head
man.
Back out onto the field. And they'll certainly be trying to get
the
first drive where they went 3 and out.
Oh, my gosh. What the hell?
To settle nerves. All you know what it's like at the start of a game with the emotion. Guys a little bit jumpy.
You do.
Oh, you understand the same way. Just like us calling one, right? Making sure we ease into the game. Let it come to us.
Well, you went
3 and out. And now they have that opportunity.
No, you didn't go 3 and out. I went 3 and out on my first drive. I'll try to do better here. This one across the 35.
All right, Amir. I see you.
It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs.
I know it's a cliche, and coaches always talk about it's a team game. We need all 11 to win. But let's face it, Detroit really needs Amir Abdullah to have runs like that all season long.
Missed a lot of time with injuries, especially recently. Now, Theo Riddick wound up leading the Lions in rushing last year with just 357 yards. And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. They go back to Abdullah on first.
Ew.
Unable to get downhill there as he'll take this up to about the 37. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
Oh. Really good run defense when you're playing a 3-4. Those three guys up front, the nose tackle and the guys they call the defensive ends, they're usually big, big people because they're going to have to eat up a lot of blockers because it's usually 5-on-3. And when they do their job well, guys who play on the inside, those inside linebackers, they will just roam and hit.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. They'll run it now out of the gun. And nice running's going to get him over the 40 to the 42. Call it a gain of 5 that time, and they'll be left with a third and about 4.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
So following the run, we'll see what they do here on third down. Off of play action, here's Stafford. Finding fouls complete. The 13 yards that time at a first. He missed on his first three passes, was 0 for 3. Now gets a connection, maybe that'll get him going.
Yeah, it wasn't a time for panic, but there was some concern because once you start in a certain pattern, you're wondering, can you get out of it? And that flips the other way, too, when you're throwing it really well. In this case, now he's got his first completion.
Damn, bro, you agree that good, too. I wouldn't expect you guys to start heading over there.
Inside the 30. Another nice gain, 16 yards there at a first down again.
There are so many things to watch for when you play defense, and reading your keys, you always hear about that, having your eyes in the right place. Sometimes your eyes can fool you. How about that play action there? That sprang the big guy, didn't it?
Able to dump it over the top to him. On first down at Stafford. Fells has it, left side. Another big hitter there, this one goes for 18. This drive has
Matthew
been a good
Stafford.
Mix. Three passing plays, three runs, hitting on all three of those passes, and the last one putting him in the red zone.
So wouldn't you think play action right here? Because you've got the ability and had the ability to run it and throw it. Go play action and take your shot at the end zone.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group.
I thought my boy was going to get lit up.
It'll be second and a couple.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. They come out here in the eye.
Matt Asiata.
They give him 2 yards there as they're set up now with a first and goal.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember the last drive, they went 3 and out.
Come back and catch that ball, bum.
Down this close to the goal line, first down.
I am, and you know I'm old school. I want to run the ball on first down in this situation because second down, that gives me an option of running play action, maybe throwing it.
So the incomplete pass brings up second down.
Damn.
And he'll actually lose a little bit of yardage here. Back to the 2. It's a loss of 2, now third down.
Ooh.
They all have habits. We can be somewhat predictable, and you know me pretty well on second down and short. What I like to see?
Play action.
Yeah, without a doubt. I thought that was a great spot to call it. Instead, didn't go their way, did it?
No, defense sold out for the run. Worked out well. Third and 2, Stafford. And he's got it.
I have no idea. I'm just glad I scored on there. There we go, Matt.
Touchdown grab. And the Lions are an extra point away from tying
this thing up. Okay, so wind's blowing a little bit. Not too bad. I just said, who's got in?
It's good, and we're all tied at 7.
Damn, that took me forever, bro.
Charles Davis, Brandon Gordon, as the Lions are in possession of the football here. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away.
Damn, Patrick P, this dude's just everywhere.
Fielded at the two.
Yeah, come get one of these, Pat. Ooh.
And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. A sidebar league-wide story,
ooh.
Charles, as these two teams make their way back onto the field. Anquan Boldin retiring after 14 NFL seasons. And boy, he is well-respected around the league, isn't he?
Boy, is he ever, and what about the accomplishments, right? What did he finish ninth in? I mean, this time, ninth in the league.
But Matt's laughing because he knows I get owned by you.
Productive.
Owned.
Gritty. The kind of guy that on third down, you had to
find
because he's going to find his way open. And no matter how difficult the catch, he seemed to come down with it. Three Pro Bowls on his resume as well. He'll be missed by the NFL.
That's a threat. You need to come in.
On second down, here's Palmer.
Hang this, I gotta go.
He's gonna air one.
Well,
this is taken in. Damn. It's complete.
Dang, Joe.
He'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
Damn, nice pass, dude.
An excellent pickup of 34 yards.
Yonza.
After the good game last play, this time they say, as he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage.
Ezekiel Ziggyonza with a tackle for loss. Just think he's still learning the game of football. Didn't play a heck of a lot of it in his native country. And at BYU, was just scratching the surface before he hit the NFL.
I feel you, Zig.
Where he really liked soccer and basketball, but football's okay for him, right?
Yeah, I think it's worked out very well. Drafted on potential.
Oh, my gosh. I can't believe I didn't hear that.
Nice. Play, Johnson. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. Give him six on the screen, but now it's third down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still ended up with a solid game.
Oh, nice. Short.
And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. The two workhorses, Palmer and Fitzgerald, connecting there for the Cardinal first.
That's a pick. All right. Let me try this. Oh my gosh, good pass.
This one all the way down inside the 15. That one goes for 24 yards.
I like.
Strength throwing the football downfield has never been an issue for this big guy. I still remember the first time I met him. He was playing for USC, and when I got introduced to him, I thought I was meeting their starting tight end, not their starting quarterback.
Such a presence, Carson Palmer.
Very much so. He's had it ever since he entered campus there, and still has it today.
On the ground, this is
Jones. John Wood.
Taken down here at about the 11. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8.
Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball on this drive, and not as much running it as we just saw once again on that last.
All right, y'all, I gotta make a stop here, man. Shit up.
But I wouldn't abandon the run totally, because otherwise, pass rushers just tee off on your quarterback, makes it very, very difficult for him in that situation.
Damn.
Ah.
Oh, feel me, baby.
His guys will get the football back.
Was he?
They were going to break the tie. The defense had other plans. They were already in field goal range.
What is this booty?
I don't know if this was a case of being a little bit too greedy with the opportunity to put points on the board.
Let's go. Let's go. Let's go, Matt. Asiata. How you gonna drop the ball, bum?
One thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown them a lot of different looks here in the first half.
Man.
They've come after them. They've sat
wow.
back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
Come on,
and they
Asiata.
Certainly have kept them on their toes.
Come
that's
on,
why
man.
They haven't had much success on the scoreboard.
You're supposed to be better than that, guys. All those simplicities. So, all you have to do is listen to them.
So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10.
Damn, dude. I feel bad, bro. My bad, Prez. Sorry.
Now oh, that's house. And he'll take this one only up to about his 13-yard line. Just a couple there on the second down run. Now they're staring at a third and 8 situation.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback on the expected passing situation.
Oh, damn.
And now with the play clock getting low, Jim Caldwell's going to signal for a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here
Let's
in this second
there.
Quarter.
Hmm. Okay. All right, all right.
The Lions on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 8.
Man, you getting that heat, bro? Golly, honey badger. Really?
Back at the 4-yard line. Here's Sam Martin now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. And he's able to get it out of there, and this is a pretty good kick. Now it's Peterson.
Oh, see, there you go. Trying to be cute.
61-yard punt. He got all of that one. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. And they'll start the drive on the ground with Johnson. A very
nice.
Good move, but for a short gain out near the 32. 2 yards on the carry there, it'll be second down.
Partner, you know I love to point out when teams break tendency and do something a little bit different from the norm. But when you run the ball in the first play of the drive, that's not a tendency breaker at all. That's just trying to establish yourself as you move forward.
Come get hit.
Gresham has it.
Wow.
Gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds.
Jermaine Gresham.
Good for 7. It's 3rd down. Short of the sticks after that completion, and now it's 3rd down for this offense.
I hope you're doing the right thing, Matt. Oh, see, there you go. Come on. Oh, wow.
And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
That sure was. That sure was. Oh, nice
stay
run.
On the ground on first with
Johnson.
Ooh.
Let's go.
Right midfield at the 49.
That's kind of blocking. With no blocks.
Down.
We appreciate that. Keep blocking like that, guys. We appreciate that. Oh, that's what's up. That's what's up.
Now Palmer to throw on second down.
I put on for my city.
And he will take this all the way down to the 38-yard line.
He sure was. It looked like it, bruh.
offense and
it looked like it, bro.
Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now. Really nice starting field position here for the offensive unit.
Oh, that's a suck.
First down throw.
Go, Matt. Let's truck somebody, Asiata. Huh, like that dude. Damn. Okay. Asiata just looking to just, man. I'm looking to drop the shoulder on one of y'all.
With 21 seconds to go here in the first half. Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground.
Oh, snap. Oh, gosh. Bruh. Throw the ball away, bruh. Damn. You big dummy.
The Lions quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 13 seconds to play in half number one.
Damn. That was a good break, too.
After the sack, Stafford and the Lions come up on a third and long situation.
Ooh, I see you, bro. I see you, Matt. Cut that back, Theo. Cut that back, Theo. Let's go. Oh, hell no. Get back, fat people. That's it.
You have 8 yards on the carry. That's going to bring up fourth down.
Oh, I couldn't have downed that anyway. That was dumb as hell. I couldn't have downed it anyway.
So when you're able to successfully move him, you're often able to get some yardage, and that's when linebackers have to clean up and make tackles. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This is taken at his four. Come here, bro. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24 yard line. So here's the Cardinals' offense now as they get set to start this third quarter. They have a chance to break our tie here as we get a look at the first drive of quarter three.
And it's such a tone setter, isn't it? Because both sides trying to seize momentum to begin the half. What do they have dialed up that'll give them an advantage?
Ooh.
The ball downfield.
Let's find out what they have dialed up. And he's able to plow forward up to about the
29. I got some little wussy safeties, bro.
Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Man, I mean, they're good. Their numbers are good, but they're not hitters. I prefer hitters over fast safeties.
A little bit surprised, though, that they got as much out as they did.
And a decent little game puts them in a pretty good spot for second down. Play action. It's Palmer.
Nice. Come here, Jermaine.
And he takes it all the way down to the 28-yard line.
Ooh.
A huge play there for Arizona. 43 yards. So here we go, first and 10 now. Fitzgerald coming in motion right.
I'm just ready for that hype, bro. I ain't giving away my secrets. Oh, that's where you going? Are you going that way?
They'll bring Fitzgerald in motion left. Tenth carry for Johnson. Might have gotten this one down to the 28, and that's all. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
Yeah, every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play.
I ain't falling for them tricks no more. Come here. I see you. Come here.
And they went for a big play through the air.
Oh, that was actually pretty good. That was a good pass.
So this is what happens when you throw interceptions. That confident veneer that you have gets chipped away a little bit. Maybe a little bit gun-shy throwing it around.
Yeah, under-throwing him there, and you're right. Those interceptions may be in the back of his mind.
Really?
Throw on third down. Palmer.
Don't do it, Palmer. Just throw that away.
Forced out to his left. And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away.
Good play.
But that brings up fourth.
A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides.
Nice.
The tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
Maybe an anxious moment or two when the ball was on its way, but he does find a way to curl it in.
Freaking Metal Gear ringtone. Kodak.
Now after the main field goal, here's Dawson.
That Solid Snake.
This one away on the kickoff.
That's what's up.
That'll be taken in the end zone.
I think I want to house this. Go, Theo. Bum.
Pass the 20 to the 23-yard line. So we get a look at the Lions offense as they get ready for their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve.
Good thing.
And a short gain there, so get it up only to about the 24. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
On second down, here's Stafford. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
And it is true. You can draft the fastest. You can draft the most athletic guys. But if they don't know the art of positioning, sometimes it's all for naught. In this case, in the right spot, help force the incompletion.
Yeah, but had his hands on it for a second. Would have been a tough catch, though. Falls incomplete. The Lions on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This is third and nine. Out of the gun, Stafford. It's caught, Jones. It's a gain of 17, and it'll give him a first down.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
Oh, he really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
Now a play fake at Stafford.
I see Matthew Peekin.
A really nice gain of 25 yards.
I see Matt Peekin, but not speaking.
So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels.
He's taking a hard body with that. All right.
Down, and he'll be taken down.
Come on, Amir, you
duty
freaking bum.
This what
Garbo, dude.
In the running game, it's hard to get back to it, because once guys get that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
And ready now for second and nine. Play faked Abdullah.
Oh,
and
my.
Stafford.
Come on, fat boy, you gotta pass up.
It's incomplete.
It's a lot of contact going on there, and in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish.
This guy play right there. This guy play is gonna take me home, country roads.
The Lions on third down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is third and 9.
Hey, you bring that heat, bro? That's what's up. I'm going to chance it anyway.
And he connects with Ebron.
We connecting, bro.
Big tight end Ebron for a Lion first down.
Ebron.
A successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action
that's
there?
Ebron, bro.
Just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
Matthew Stafford is just, ain't that dude's a ball. Oh, snap. Oh, word.
Fake here on first down. Sliding out of the pocket. And this is going to be caught.
Man, let's go, man. You can give that to me.
So it's incomplete.
Stupid game.
Eric Ebron, the big tight end, his intended target. And now it's second down.
Man. He's stupid. All right. Let's do it anyway.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage. Look defensively. Open space inside the 10. And he takes this one in for a Lions touchdown. Amir Abdullah, a 23-yard run. And the Lions have taken the lead.
I know we don't talk about it enough, but the intelligence level of the guys up front blocking, the offensive linemen, maybe the smartest guys in football overall. Addle in a little bit of athleticism and a whole lot of toughness, you've got a lot to deal with, don't you?
That's why the guys in the backfield get them really nice Christmas gifts, right?
If they're smart, they do.
Yeah, are you playing pup after this?
To kick it away.
Oh, okay.
This one fielded at the 5.
Huh.
And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And after the last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them wanted to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal.
Ziggy.
But you met fan bases that wanted that.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants to drive in with a kick. Other than the extra point, that's it.
Oh, shoot, man. Ain't that offense some baloney? You know what? We just about to bring in. That's how we feel, bro. That's just how we feel right there.
Big hit at the 29.
Why don't you counter that?
Loses 3 yards there. Now third down. The Cardinals on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is third and 4.
Oh, snap. You did not just do that.
From the shotgun, it's Palmer.
Short.
Here, complete to his tight end. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. They stop him for only 3 that time, and that'll bring up 4th down. And now the Lions going to stop us momentarily as they call a timeout. It's just their first, so 2 remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. And now it's the punter Weil on as he sends this one away.
Let's go, Theo. We'll talk.
And it's taken in at the 9. And he is out of bounds, getting it across the 30-yard line. A very nice job on the run back there. He'll get 23 yards all told. And the Lions will take over. This will probably be the last play of the quarter. And they begin the drive with a duel.
Nice.
He's going to be stopped here for no gain. And that's going to take us to the end of the third quarter of play. And on second and 10 now. Again, it's Abdullah. And some room to work. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Give him 11 yards
you, Amir.
And a new set of downs.
I'm guessing I see you put in that word.
Here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely, you want to bleed
things out. Hold up, babe. Right?
Possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense.
Oh, my God.
What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
He didn't seem in a rush. I guess they just didn't know where the play clock was.
I think you're right about that, because there was no hurried movements there, right? No up-tempo at all. Clock just ran out. I think he was as surprised as maybe his bench was.
Stafford. He's going to find
his
way
truck.
Back. It's complete.
Let's go, Matt.
And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40. That's good for 21 yards and a first down.
Matt, I'll see
you. So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football.
Hey, shut up.
That's why sometimes you swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Stafford gives to Abdullah. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9. Run blitz there defensively, something we might see more of here in the fourth quarter.
I think we'll see a lot of it, and the difference between that and a pass blitz, you're just trying to get to the quarterback. You're trying to scheme someone open who will get to the QB and make sure he gets on the ground. In a run blitz, you're actually trying to cover up gaps, trying to cover up holes so they can't run the football.
Play clock winding down. Off of play action, here's Stafford. And pressure will bring him down here. The Cardinals get home for the sack. Frosty Rucker in there to get him for his second sack of the night. After the sack, Stafford and the Lions come up on a third and long situation. And the play clock's running down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. A good pickup there, 7 yards, but it brings up fourth down.
And that's the kind of run that gets everyone excited on offense. And, you know, oftentimes the guys who carry the ball are the ones in the huddle doing the tripping. Right now I think it's the offensive line telling them, run it again. Yep. We are right yep. there about to break the lead.
Fucking
And this
oh
is
my God,
target
bro.
To the left. Didn't get there anyway. It's no good. And the score will stay right where it is.
Boy, it's just straight up talking me to death.
Okay, he just never got the ball on target. And knowing him, he'll be disappointed with that effort.
The offense certainly looking to score some points, but they also need ball security here late as we get down to the final moments of this one. They go play action now. Palmer. He's going deep for
nice
Brown.
Pass.
It's caught at the 10. And all the way down to the 9. A big time play there by the Cardinals. 45 yards. They'll try and run. This is Johnson. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. And this defense here going to burn their second timeout. But you can also factor in another timeout that they'll get when the clock stops at the 2-minute warning. And leading here late, so a chance for the defense to really close out this game if they can halt the offense. The throw on second down. Palmer.
Oh my gosh. Dude, that was freaking nice. I thought he was still going to be... I thought he was still going to be Z-ing out. That was slick as hell.
10 yards out, and the Cardinals have taken the lead here in the fourth.
That's what's up.
And it's good. Well, that could be a critical miss.
Oh, gosh. I don't even. I can't even kick a field goal.
Like, and I don't know, man. I think there's just too many damn things hooked up to this freaking.
This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. So the Lions offense ready to go back out onto the field. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker.
This is it, Stafford. Shoot, man. This is what ballers ball. This is what bums go home.
But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. It's a gain of a yard, and it takes us to the 2-minute warning. Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this.
Okay. Bro, you coming in hot? Okay.
Stafford now on second down. And Jones has it over the middle. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. 8 yards on the completion. But now they
only one way to find out.
Remember, Stafford was the king of the comeback in 2016. 8 of them. Can he do it again here?
I witnessed a run of 3 in a row by Matthew Stafford and the Lions in 2016. He definitely has the capability of getting it done again.
Break that tackle, son. Bum.
It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains.
Bruh,
as well.
You real gutsy, ain't you? I like you. Okay. Let's try one of these then.
So the run gets him the first, and now they operate with a fresh set of downs. Back to throw. To the right and complete to Galladay. And he is out of bounds on the other side of midfield. That one goes for 13 yards and it moves the sticks. That's what they need right now. Get the first down, get out of bounds, stop the clock.
Just playing smart football, understanding the situation, making the plays necessary, and making sure that clock stops at every opportunity.
He's back to throw.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Oh, just dodged one. Oh, like they're not coming here too. It's just a clutch moment.
What exactly is going on? Is he a little bit dinged up here, or is it just off just by a bit? Maybe he can get it back in this situation. He'll need to.
I actually got a score touched on here, dude. Or at least get like freaking up to the damn 10-15. Otherwise, I'm screwed. I might get picked. Oh, wow. Are you kidding me? Bruh.
A good pick up there, 26 yards.
It should have been. I know, shoot. Oh, that wasn't PP, that's why. Ooh-wee. No, PP was on the other side. What? That's crazy, bro. Well, I'm grateful it didn't happen.
Offense still needing 10 yards. Second down. And now whistles and a flag. And I think we got a jump here. A free 5 yards as the defense jumps.
I know it's an
bro, your boys are they imploding right now?
Reaction game, and they reacted poorly on that one.
And the defense with their backs against the wall a little bit here as the offense is in the red zone. Now contact up front as penalty markers come in.
What?
Who is this against? Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave him with two remaining. We'll be back after this.
I really don't know what to do, bro. You know what? I'll try it. Shoot or shoot. That's what Clem said.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. A gain of 3, second down. Stafford barking out signals and trying to get his guys set quickly.
He'll
spike it here with 13 seconds showing on the clock. The Lions on third down. 5 out of 9 thus far. This is 3rd and 7. They'll run it now out of the gun. And taken down.
What?
He does have first down yardage. And whistles.
Come on,
and
bro.
They take their final timeout with
garbage.
7 seconds left.
Yeah, now I gotta go for a damn field goal. My freaking team sucks nuts.
So here's the veteran kicker, Matt.
Where are you,
and
icing
here
me?
Come the
That's
whistles and a timeout with 7 seconds left.
Give me some ice.
So here's the veteran kicker, Matt Prater. He missed his only attempt earlier. This time he's going for the win. And the 10-year vet knocks it through the goalpost. And it's celebration time on that sideline as they have taken the lead in the final seconds. If you know, in an era of cost-cutting and maximizing your roster, this is a club that does not skimp on special teams, and in these situations, it pays dividends.
And that's great vision by the organization. When the difference between winning or losing depends on who you have kicking the ball, would you rather have a street free agent
or like
a
freedom
pro like this? Answer's pretty evident to me. And when you're facing a deficit on the scoreboard, you're just looking for something to get you right back into the game, and that's the spark that they were looking for. They got it with that big return.
Oh my God, here we go.
And they're going to go soft on the corners. One last shot for Palmer. Well, we saw a close game that kept us on the edge of our seats down to that final whistle. And right before that final whistle, defense with one last exclamation mark, they're getting the sack to end it.
I love how you phrased it because...
Matt, bro, you cracked me up. Let's see here. Hold up, Jody. Thank you.